Time to talk about vanadium. It's something that Vincent Algar from Australian Vanadium is well across. In fact, he's at the Battery Minerals Conference at the moment. But before we get to what the sentiment is like, Vincent, can you just tell us about the banking feasibility study that has just come out and why it's important, why investors should care?
Hi, Ky. Yeah, good to be back with Proactive again. Yeah, look, we released our bankable feasibility study yesterday, a major milestone for the company. It is a strong, robust study with a very, very good technical underpinning. We've been through every corner of it. There's huge amounts of work in there, and it's taken our company some time to get sure that's done, get it out there. And we are very comfortable where it is on a financial basis, despite the inflationary environment we find ourselves in, and many other companies do. It's a pretty tough time, probably the toughest time in not just 5 years, but probably 40 years to be putting out a project. So we're very happy with where we landed. The vanadium price is playing ball. It's moving strongly in the right direction as well. So making those financials look pretty good going forward in terms of delivery. So it's a key milestone for us en route to production and funding for this project. And because it's at the level of the study that it's been done at, which is plus or minus 15%, by our engineers at Wood and the rest of our technical advisors and teams, it unlocks discussions with key funding bodies such as Export Finance Australia, who are very keen at the moment to fund these critical mineral projects, such as we saw with their support of the Aluka project just a few days ago. And in fact, the government grant we received just a few weeks ago towards the funding of the project.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that $49 million from the government. I mean, what is the expected impact? Can you give us a little more detail on that?
Yeah, look, we put an application in last year to participate in the company in the federal government's collaboration critical mineral grant scheme. It's called the scheme itself is about collaboration and manufacturing. And they were very keen in getting involved in sectors where the supply chains were critical, like vanadium, critical for our trading partners, dominated by where those supply chains are dominated by China. And we have the capacity to build supply chain security for ourselves and our partners. And that's why our application was well received. We also have some collaboration in there with ATCO for new hydrogen production and kickstarting the hydrogen industry with some offtake locally, which is a very exciting part of this project as well. And then working with other partner, Briar Resources and BYH, where we'll be looking at taking advantage of the base metal credits in the vanadium project itself, which comes out of our tailings. So some exciting stuff there, but that's the grant. The grant will be well managed and audited by our team and our funding team. But what it is there for is to kickstart the project and get it into production and get that supply chain under control. So it's attracted a heap of attention to the company. It's really reinforced our position as the next global vanadium producer, primary vanadium producer. And it actually, because it's from government, gives investors confidence to investors, and particularly those investors here and overseas. It does make all the Australian taxpayers stakeholders in the project success. So we know that responsibility that brings to us. And I was able to, leading to the conference, Minister Pitt opened the conference yesterday morning, and I was able to catch up with him and thank him for putting us in line for this grant and getting us underway.
Yeah, well, certainly just a quick glance at the current geopolitical climate just reminds people why China and Russia, who are the two largest vanadium producers, why they would probably be leaving quite a lot of demand for Australia, being the third largest vanadium source at the moment. So, okay, you mentioned the conference there. Well, what's the sentiment been like? It sounds like it's been quite positive there then.
Yeah, absolutely great. A number of participants this year all across the battery metal space, all the lithium producers and near producers and explorers, and a lot of companies that are in the nickel, cobalt, copper space as well. Some great people that I've met there. that we've all been working on really hard to shift and bring a lot of these deposits into reality. And my colleagues across all the other different sectors. And but the exuberance and enthusiasm in the sector, because not only pricing, but also the real shift it brings towards the decarbonization of society and the jobs it creates in the process of doing so. The importance of mining are really, really critical out there. So we were also able to highlight the importance of vanadium in energy storage and the long duration capacity. And so we've got a good hearing and lots of attention at our booth as well, and with the online presentations from that conference. It's a strong activity across the sector, and we believe strong delivery in the coming years.
Okay, excellent. Well, looking forward to hearing more then. Vincent Algar from Australian Vanadium, look forward to talking to you again soon.
Thanks, Ky.